Good evening. It's my pleasure to welcome you to our spring concert, and we're going to get started right away. This is our Full House a cappella ensemble. I have a public service announcement. It sounds as though there's a black Honda CRV that's running. Oh. That's right.
Peter Hazard, who is here tonight.
Peter Hazard, how are you?
There he is!
there's a lot of names of cities tossed around throughout the course of the song. We hope you like it. We called it Love and the Orient Express.
Featuring Ted!
This next selection, we just love to sing, and actually, they're going conductorless. This is an English madrigal, and it was done in the style of, kind of something you do in the living room, you know, to pass the time when there wasn't television. Yeah? All right, good. This next selection is one of two choral scherzos that Gail Kubik wrote, and they're based on lovely American folk songs. This one, obviously, based on Polly Wally Doodle. Features a trio in the middle, and this is our, we call it our sophomore trio. Includes Micaiah Jones, give it away. There we go. Jennifer Puzo, and Shane Braz. This next selection will present at graduation this year. It's an arrangement of a Green Day tune, obviously. It's in the program. And features on the solo lines are our collective seniors. Yeah. Certainly one of the hardest working ensembles I've ever had the pleasure to work with. And I credit the seniors for that work ethic. These are great people. Moms and dads out there can be really proud of these folks. They're terrific. Anyway, this is... Another turning point, a fork stuck in. next selection, Shenandoah, based on a traditional tune, is one of my favorite tunes, and this arrangement is by far my favorite arrangement. It's arranged by a lot of people in a lot of different settings. This is a classic treatment by Marshall Bartholomew. So I'm going to play the piano for this one, and I forgot to put in the program, Austin Sullivan is going to play the drums.
Thank you.
Such is our tradition. We're going to sing for you a piece called Moving On, and we're going to play a slideshow that honors our graduating seniors. And we're going to segue into another piece that we traditionally sing at this point in our program, and our paths meet again, at which time we'll hope that any alumni of our program who might be out there will join us here on the Rogers. Okay. You know the plan. Thank you. Thank you very much. We're going to invite you to enjoy some of your riffing, grab some popcorn, and we'll see you for the second half with our instrumental music program.
Hi, everyone. So our first song, Don Pedro, there's a story attached to this one. I had never heard it before I got to Peabody, and I believe it was like my second year here. Someone said, can we do this song? It's in the library, and the Portuguese band does it. And so I'm like, okay, we'll give it a try. It's one of my absolute favorites, and I don't think there's a single song that we've ever done that has nearly the level of energy of Don Pedro. So. Again, one of our favorites, crowd favorite. Our next song, on the other hand, some of you that have been around that have older siblings, or many of you are older siblings, we did this next song a long time ago. It's called Crystals. We're actually going to try to give you a full effect. It's not just auditory, you're gonna have some visual effects too. And so, I'm not gonna give anything away, just here we go, Crystals. All right, so Crystals is one of my pet projects, which is aleatoric or chance music. Music where the composer says, performers, do something like this, but make it up on your own. It's very scary for a band director, and very few school systems around do this style of music at all. I think it's essential for high school band student to learn that whole avenue of music, something that most high school band students never see, and if you said it to them, they wouldn't even know what the word meant. And these kids know it, and that song is incredibly difficult, and they did a wonderful job. So, good job. We have several transitions coming up, and now I think is the best time to be able to do this next part, which is to have all of our seniors that are performing in your last spring concert. Why don't you stand up so we can see who you are. Gentlemen, you will be missed. You will be missed.
Yes.
You can see. All right, the Wind on Concert Band, sorry, the Concert Band's last song is called Aventura. This is by James Swearingen, who's one of my favorite composers. And without further ado, here's Aventura.
Thank you.
as I said, we have a couple transitions. The first transition is going to be transitioning over to the wind ensemble, which is just like this concert band, only about 5% of them. So we've got a lot of people to move, but not a lot of stuff, so we should be really quick. So thank you very much, and here comes the wind ensemble. Some of them are still tuning because they have to switch horns, but I wanted to talk about the wind ensemble this year. It's been many, many years since I've felt comfortable having the wind ensemble perform on the trip. And these guys have really, really devoted time and effort to wind ensemble, which if you're not sure what wind ensemble is here at Peabody High, it is an extra ensemble that meets one night a week. So these people here all volunteered to give up a night of the week. An additional one, some of them are already in jazz band, so that's two nights of the week to combat their sports schedules, their homework schedules, if they were in stage one as well, to devote to more band time. And this is the first year, like I said, in lots of years, that I felt comfortable having them perform on the trip, and they performed wonderfully on the trip. And you're going to get two of the songs they played in New Jersey tonight. So, are we good? Yeah? The first song we're going to play is called The King's Musicians. It's actually a transcription. It's music that was written for orchestra, actually music that was written for orchestra hundreds of years ago, several hundreds of years ago, and was then rewritten for wind ensemble. So most of my instruments back here, except maybe Austin, the oboe and the flute, they're taking the role of instruments that they are not. Clarinets are mostly violins. The trumpets and French horns, though they might have had a trumpet or a French horn here or there, they're probably violas. The saxophones are definitely violas or cellos. The tenors are cellos. The barys are basses. So we're trying to be string instruments tonight, except Austin. He's already a string instrument.
Song.
for the next piece, In the Winter of 1730, the composer has given some notes for me to read to you. This dramatic composition is a musical portrait that reflects nearly 300 years of Ohio history. Inspired by the Portsmouth Flood Wall Murals, a popular tourist attraction, which features 2,000 square feet of art along the beautiful Ohio River. In the Winter of 1730 is crafted in four continuous movements. The first, Shawnee Village, 1730. I lost my spot, sorry. Reflects a winter scene of a Shawnee Indian village with a view of the north looking across the Ohio River. Two, 1812. Powerful drums introduced the Battle of Thames, where Tecumseh, chief of the Shawnee Indians, lost his life. Three, Portsmouth, 1903. A Copland introduction is followed by a lively rendition of original folk music. Both helped to make the city of Portsmouth, Ohio, come to life at the turn of the 20th century. And four, The Beauty of the River. A beautiful and expressive theme brings this work to a glorious and highly impressive finish. I hope you enjoy In the Winter of 1730.
Thank you.
on to that. Next of those transitions I talked about, we're going to be swooping back down here to jazz band and do a quick sound check, and then we'll be right into jazz band. Thank you for your patience. Hi, everyone. Austin has a fan club. So, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to close the evening with our jazz band. This group meets for 2 hours every Tuesday night this year, and that transition worked out really immensely well because most people didn't have sports conflicts, and we actually had really great attendance. I was afraid. I had to move things so I could get home right after school to get Morgan off the bus, and I said, oh, this is going to kill my jazz band. And it didn't. It actually made them better. They worked together, they were stronger, and hopefully you'll hear the results of that tonight. We're going to open with a band favorite. I'm guessing it's going to be a fan favorite. This is Uptown Funk.
Thank you.
with that featured Mr. Kyle Souza on the tenor saxophone, Mr. Neil Salmon on the trombone, and this guy, I don't know if you've met him, his name is Austin Sullivan, he plays the bass. All right, this next song is titled The Very Thought of You, Very, not The Very Thought of You, the... Oh, I just got it. So this is going to feature Nicholas McLaughlin on the baritone saxophone. Last song is called Area 51. This song is going to feature a lot of people, and I'm going to probably call them out in advance so I don't Forget Anyone's gonna feature Nicholas McLaughlin on the Barry, Kyle on the tenor, Neil on the trombone, Dylan on the guitar, Austin on the bass. Did I miss anyone? Good. And Robert Stocker on the... Yeah! And Robert Stocker on the trumpet. This is our last song of the evening. After this, we're going to have the band's version of the slideshow. I would like to thank you all for coming and supporting these students doing these wonderful things. You have no idea how hard they work. You have no idea how much they amaze me every day. And if it weren't for you all driving them places, I would never see them. So if nothing else, thank you for that. I remember my parents driving me to stuff, and I never, ever thanked them. And then I got my own car, and they thanked me because they didn't have to get off the couch anymore. But really, it's as simple as that. Really, getting them here, these kids do wonderful things. And if it weren't for you all, they wouldn't do any of it. So thank you so much for letting me teach your students.
Thank you.
shower. Can we turn off the lights that are above my head?
Oh. Thank you.